Hey, what's up? I'm Pranay, Pranay J. Reddy. I'm a first-year student here at the Champalimaur Center for the Unknown. But for the people who don't know, it's one of the most premier research institutes in cancer and neuroscience, and in clinical studies too. But the name, Center for the Unknown,
Spooky,
and
mysterious.
why is it unknown? Why is it named like that? Is it specifically named to make it sound mysterious? I really don't know. But over the course of the year, that's what we hope to do. We hope to declassify, demystify, and also bring more exposure on the people and how we live here. So, while it is the Center for the Unknown, love that name, we hope to make it much more known. So, let's start with me. I, like I said, I'm a first-year student in Champalimaur, and I just started my journey last month. And yes, that is me standing behind the letters, Champalimaur Center for the Unknown. Yep, that's more representative of my face. I'm from Chennai, India. So on September 4th, I embarked on this journey for 16 hours or 14 hours. I don't remember, it's too long. Then I arrived to be greeted by my batchmates, Kerem, because Champalimaur was kind enough to organize an Airbnb for the first month, such that me and the rest of my batchmates who from outside the country can come stay in a place. Speaking of my batch, these are my batches: Miguel, Kerem, Arjun, Devanshi, Arina, Guillermo, Anna, Madalena, Beatrice, and Robert, who, for purposes not explained in this video, doesn't appear here. It was actually kind of interesting for me because I see too many open spaces. It's a cliche thing being an Indian saying this, but it's no people at all. It is cool. I personally like it, but I get it. Now I get it when people say, like, oh my God, like, there's so many people in India. Unbeknownst to us, Champalimaur was delivering and preparing for this kick-ass orientation week. Really cool orientation week. My God, was it fun. So what did we do that was so fun? We had lectures, pretended to be stuff we were not. We had an improvisation class, got inspired by professors, maybe too inspired by professors, and just started to feel that PhD hitting us. It's too soon for that. We saw a seagull, went surfing, got some cool looking pictures. That's why you do surfing. Went to a cooking class, learned how to make traditional dishes, such as the fish with no taste and a pastry with too much egg in it. I really don't know. Yes, I know I'm gonna get a lot of flak and a lot of disrespect from Portuguese people here, but come on. You cannot have a dish with meat in it with no taste, and you can't have too much egg in a pastry and not have chocolate on it. Come on now. Got to meet the clubs. We have the book club, basketball club, everything you can eat club, bakery club, people standing around club. Yeah, the club. Yeah, clubs for everything. And there's the stuff which I didn't even know existed, like salsa club. I thought salsa was a dish. I couldn't ask for more because it was really, really fun, and I really do thank all the people who helped organize this, the students and also the people who helped organize it. And so, you know, I thought, you know, why not get a few words from them?
Most fun standing up on the surfboard. That was my personal highlight.
So I did the pastel de nata thing with you guys, and I saw you guys all having fun with the workshop.
Cooking workshop.
And yeah, the surf was also very.
So that was my first 2 weeks in September, and it was pretty very. One was pretty mild, and one was way too intense. But then the courses started. But surprisingly enough, I did not expect the courses to be designed this way. So each week has a theme. So for example, my first week or our first week was fundamentals in neuroscience, and we are a batch made of neuroscience and cancer students. So it was pretty basic, at the same time a bit advanced for some people.
I know we have a diverse pool of people. Some people come from pure math, from pure physics, from biology with little neuroscience, and we want to also give, for the same reason, a common knowledge that is the basic fundamentals that will allow you to then read more advanced things and learn more things, but you need to refresh or learn the basics.
So yeah, that week went by fast too. Thankfully, it wasn't that hard. Who knows? Maybe it was just the first week, so I just got off easy. So now it was the physiology and cancer week. It was different than I expected it to be because we had this thing known as PBL, which, if I remember correctly, is known as peanut butter lessons. personal baby lessons, project-based learning, programming. I really don't know. Turns out it was quite fun. I actually learned a lot. We all work together as a group. Any one thing I can speak of is the fact that we have been a pretty tight-knit group since the beginning. And to top it off, we also had a competition amongst ourselves as to figure out who was actually going to win the Nobel Prize. I'm not going to lie, I never paid attention to the Nobel Prize winners as much as I did this past couple of weeks. On a personal note, went to downtown Lisbon and had chicken biryani. Missed that from home. That was my month in September in Champalimaur. Over the course of the next few months, I'll probably will be interviewing some of my own batchmates to get their perspectives as new PhD students, how are we settling in? Or you might be getting interviews and sharing experiences from people who've been here for much more longer and see how they've adapted their lifestyles according to being a researcher here. So hope you like this video. If you have any comments or suggestions, please do let us know. And that's me, Pranaji Reddy, signing off. Bye-bye.